Okay.
Thank you.
Thank you, Madam Pui, who is the chairman of the session. And thank you also, Mr. Ramin Granfer, for who helped us for the inception of this project. And as he said, that the idea came, the conceived the idea of the project came after the Kenya meetings. Then we have developed this inclusive cultural heritage products development for the enrichment of tourism in Ethiopia. Therefore, this project is designed based on the developmental goal, eradication of poverty in the vicinity of the targeted cultural heritage sites, because Ethiopia is one of the ancient East African countries, which has 80 million peoples and various cultural heritage, which now the world UNESCO registered 8 of them as a world cultural heritage. Therefore, now one of the targeted of this development goal is eradication of poverty in the vicinity of the targeted cultural heritage sites, who traditionally for long years and even for centuries has a knowledge of now crafts industries, local craft industries. Therefore, the developmental goal is now based on our strategic transformation strategic plan, which is designed recently, which will be effective as of this year, and based on the DTIS and EIF. What are the rationales behind this project is that, as you know, Ethiopia, even though it is rich in historical and cultural heritage, as I said, 7 of it are historical and archaeological heritage, and 1 is natural heritage. No much benefited now get from this heritage. Therefore, we need to have ensure the local population derive tangible benefits from the tourist industry. Because whenever the tourist industries now go to the destination areas, they don't get the necessary crafts industries developed, and the local population also not interested for the tourist industries, for the tourism. Just when you look at the tourism flows in Ethiopia, over 80% of arrivals now arrived through Addis Ababa Airport, and the number of tourists who have visited the country over the last 5 years was now estimated to be 1.8 million. And the main tourist destinations are the northern part of Ethiopia. There is a big historical route from Addis Ababa to Bahrdar, which is one of the northern regions, and across Gondar, which is one of the World Heritage Sites, and Aksum, another World Heritage Sites, and Mekelle and Lalibela, which is the best and the most tourist destination areas of tourism in Ethiopia. The other destinations are partly in the southern part of Ethiopia, where about 56 ethnic national groups existed, and they have their own unique and distinctive cultures and crafts. Who are the main tourists, the tourist visitors in Ethiopia? 36% of tourists came from Europe, which 33% of from Africa, 40% from the Americas, and 12% from the Middle East countries, which most of them holiday makers, business travelers, and conference participants. As you know, Addis Ababa is also one of the center where the head of the OAU is existed. Therefore, there were so many meetings where ECA also there. So 60% of all arrivals now came from the foreign tourists. The age of profile arrivals indicates that the economically active age groups are of 25 to 44 and 45 to 59, together representing about 56 of total arrivals. What Ethiopia gets from this tourism revenues? In the 40s, from 2005 to 2008, average annual revenue of the country was $167 million. Now we put simply to show that the extent. Now we presented here, now Ethiopia now don't benefit much from the tourism industry. From these 4 consecutive years, as 21% of annual growth rate for tourists arrivals and 19.5% for revenue. Therefore, the contribution of this travel and tourism to gross domestic product is only remained 8.9%. Compared to the neighboring countries, if you compare this figure with the neighboring countries, Ethiopia has still attracted a small number of tourists, in spite of the fact that Ethiopia has many destination tourist attractive World Heritage Site. Still, the income from the tourist industry is still very limited. The Ethiopian travel and tourism economy is also ranked number 94 in absolute size worldwide and 89 in relative contribution to the national economies. So what are the problems faced for the craft industries, for the private sectors? Just we designed this project to link, to establish a strong link between the local communities and the tour agents and the other social groups now who hitherto now not benefited from the tourist industry. So at the policy level, we have identified our problems. There is a lack of clear strategy for development of tourism. At the production level, the producers have some constraints in developing new design. They have a big design problems, even though for long years, for centuries now they adopted the production process of traditional crafts. They have a problem of designing. So we assess this problem. The other is inconsistency and poor quality of supplies, which doesn't fit the demands. Lack of technical supports, like trainings to producers and inadequate work premises, and at the same time, working capital constraints. And the other is marketing problem, lack of standard and branding, access to information on market requirements, poor conditions along the value chain. So that's how the project approaches to these problems. The project now focuses on achieving tangible results and direct benefits to the producers, and make it work like a business, create a commercially viable model linkage clusters of low-income producers who are located in heritage sites of handcrafts to the local tourism market, follow the demand, start at sites where there are most tourists, then expand nationally as well as internationally, and build on enhanced existing know-how. Already the knowledge is there. The problem is that how to design, redesign, recreate, and to be innovative so that they can compete with the markets. This is one of the projects should address. And learn from others' best practices. Now, we shared best ideas. For example, last month, we have got some best practices from Kenya. So we developed those ideas. So what the project where the beneficiaries groups? The beneficiaries are, from now, for the purpose of this project, three World Heritage Sites, communities and artisans who are living in the three heritage sites, one tourist destination areas, where the three heritage sites, Aksum, Harar, and Lalibela, and one of the southern routes, destination of tourism in Gamo, which is the southern part of Ethiopia, which the people were known for are known for the production of local traditional textiles. And special attention will be paid to the full participation of women and youth, because the most important role played by women and the youth for these crafts. Therefore, all over 1,000 craftsmen will be selected from four sites, which one now encompass 250 artisans and crafters. What are the products in these areas, in these destination areas? The selected sites: jewelry, fashion accessories, leatherware, handloom, textiles, embroidery, baskets, religious arts and crafts, pottery, and other traditional crafts are producing in the areas. And if you design and material the project, what are the expected outputs from this project? At the policy and strategy level, we design to sector development strategy. At the production level, producer cluster formed and legally registered as commercial entities. Now they have the problem of legal problems and unity and make organizations. And new and innovative designs for various types of handcrafts developed, produced and sold in the local market for tourists. The other is we should address at the output level the market, comprehensive market plans, new market linkage created and business generated between hotels, shops and tourism, tour operators and alternative outlets created like shops, display center for producers to sell directly to tourists. Expected project outcomes: greater efficiency and productivity in the handicraft sector at the outcome level, improved incomes of participating artisans, higher motivation of local population to preserve cultural heritage sites, enhanced the image of Ethiopian handicrafts and the social status of the artisans, which so far now the artisans are somehow marginalized socially, so that we should tackle that problems also. Diversified income opportunities. Okay, I'm running because I fear that the time will be okay. So that the expected projected outcome is, the one is greater efficiency and productivity. in the handicraft center. We want to develop the handicraft centers, the handicraft sector, with efficiently and more productively. The other is improved incomes of participating artisans. One of the problems is income. The more they produced for centuries, but the lifestyle, the living standards of these traditional crafters in the four heritage sites are not improved. This creates a problem and attitude towards the tourists. For example, if the tourists go to Lalibela, it doesn't care for the local community whether the tourists come to Lalibela or not, because the life, the living conditions, the livelihood of the community has not changed. So we try to link this, the problem, the social standards, the living conditions of the people to, in relation with the tourist industries, in relation to the traditional crafts.